I've done with the unboxing of this earlier on, so now we'll do the in-depth review of this netbook from Sony. If anyone had missed the unboxing, I'll quickly show you the ports again. Very quickly, there are three USB ports from one side and the usual Ethernet VGA port and the Pro Duo slot and the SD slot on the other side. From the front, there is no such thing, there is just this wireless switch and the power button, along with the headphone jack and the microphone jack. So we'll check it out now from the inside. And the keyboard is, as you can see, so I've tried it out, it's actually very comfortable. I mean, it looks small, but it works fine. And the trackpad is, well, it's an average trackpad, but the size is, it's a decent size, and two separate buttons, which is not found in most of the netbooks today. So let's see how it works. It does have the Windows 7 starter version, so might take a little too long to start, so you'll need to be a bit more patient. It does have a motion eye camera, as Sony calls it, a small web camera and a microphone along with it. That does come handy sometimes when you're outdoors, and there are two speakers out there that are of average quality again. Very small size, I mean, how much do you expect from a small netbook? Still starting. Now what happened, I've placed it so that's in such a way so the direct sunlight falls on the screen, so that you can see the matte screen, how it works. I mean, it's a very bright screen, as with most of the Sony VAIO laptops. It's a very bright screen, and you can see that there is no such glossy surface, so you can clearly see everything outdoors as well. Some of the software pre-installed, the McAfee 30-day trial, and some spyware, anti-spyware, yeah, the Spy Sweeper, and 90-day trial of that, the Microsoft Office 60-day trial, and rest the usual softwares that do come with Sony VAIO. Alright, so I think we're done with the startup. I'll show you the inside of this. Now, something special about Sony VAIO, you have this VAIO gate. Let me start this application. Now here it is, it sticks up on the top. You can keep it in a like this. You can see the RSS feeds coming up now. If you just roll the mouse over, you can see the small application. This is called the VAIO gate. Yeah, as I say, there is the webcam application, VAIO control center, Sony VAIO Evernote, Internet Explorer, and the Excel Word. Apart from the Media Plus and other VAIO services, there was something different in that you won't find in other netbooks. The battery, it says, it's around 88% right now. So, but I mean, if you keep Wi-Fi on and brightness below 50%, I think it does give about 5 hours, not more than 5 hours, I'd say. But still, it's alright when you consider the 6L battery doesn't stick out. So you should be happy with the 5 hours. I mean, if you want more battery backup, it's a 3800 mAh battery, I guess, because usually 6L batteries are 5200, so maybe that's a little different than this. The rest is as usual. As I told you already about its specs, it's slightly different than the other VAIO M variants in market, as course they come with the 1GB RAM. This one comes with 2GB. That's slightly different. The rest is N470 1.83 GHz processor. System ratings, yeah, that's something important. It's not showing it up. Come on. think it was something around 2.5, yeah, 2.5, the system ratings. It's fine in a netbook. I mean, it's still a small netbook. I mean, how much do you expect from this one? There is one more application that comes in Sony VAIO laptops. It's called the VAIO Media Plus. We'll check it out first. Yeah, those of you who have used the PlayStation Portable or PS3 must be familiar with this kind of layout. It's this Media Plus application. You can browse your pictures, videos, and your music files over here. You just have to control it as you do it in your PSP or PS3. There are no videos or audio. I can browse your images, everything from this application. That was VAIO Media Plus. The other thing is about netbooks. Well, if you want to browse the internet, I'll prefer the Google Chrome browser, and I'll show you why. Let me close this application first. Now, this goes with all the netbooks. Now, Google Chrome is why I prefer it, because I mean, I don't think the internet is working on it right, because the space over here is much more than Internet Explorer or Firefox. Yeah, people do prefer Firefox over other browsers, but in netbooks I don't think anything can be better than Google Chrome, because it's light, it's fast, it boots up in no time, and if you press F11 it can go in full screen. And otherwise it's very light. The other thing you can do in your netbook, you can hide the taskbar. Just go to properties and use auto hide taskbar. It further increases your usage area. You can see that, and when you roll your mouse down over here, you can see the taskbar pops up. I hope you can see that. Otherwise, if you don't like this, just turn it back off. Don't auto hide the taskbar. That's it. For videos, I think I've tried VLC Media Player. There are other versions as well, like Comp Player or the Real Player. I don't know if you like it, but I've checked out many reviews on these things, so I think VLC is pretty good. It plays almost any sort of file you like. And I'm gonna show you one HD video, how it works on this. I've noticed that HD video 720p works fine if you run it from like Windows Media Player, but when I tried playing it from some other player, like Real Player or the GOM Player, it doesn't work fine. So I'll show you it from the Media Player, Windows Media Player. You'll find it in all the Windows 7 MacBooks.